Hi guys, Nick Jennison for Guitar Interactive Magazine, and today we're having a look at the Focusrite Clarett 2PREUSB. Now this little audio interface is the USB cousin to Focusrite's very, very highly thought of Thunderbolt-based Clarett preamp series. So Clarett USB, it's a USB 3 interface, so it's nice and quick, it's very, very modern affair. It's quite simple in terms of features, and it's a format that we are all pretty familiar with by this point. Two in, four out interface, expandable with ADAT on the back, which is really quite exciting. Let's talk about some of the features that we got going on in here. First of all, we have these two combi jacks for XLR or quarter inch jack input. And you'll notice there are a few little lights down here. We have an instrument level and we have air, which is quite cool. I'll just show that to the camera. We'll get onto that in a second. That's Focusrite's kind of like trademark air preamp, which is really lovely to see in an interface of this size. It's a nice way of kind of getting a little bit of kind of color on the go, if you will. We'll talk about that in a second. Very positive feeling gain controls with this kind of ring LED, tells you where you're at. We all know how that works by now. 48 volt phantom power available independently on each channel with this push button. We have a large dial for controlling your monitor mix, which we can assign. It's preset to outputs 1 and 2 on the back, but we're going to assign that in the Focusrite Control app. Headphones over here, again, independent of the monitors, which is quite nice. And then we've got a few LEDs to let you know that we have power, let you know we have USB connection, and let me know that we have sample rate sync, which is very, very cool. On the front, there's not an awful lot more to talk about. Let's spin it around. We'll have a peek on the back. So what you can see, on-off switch, a little power receptacle down there. Now this device is, it's possible to bus power it, but only if you're using a USB Type-C socket. The old kind of traditional USB outlets just don't provide quite enough power. So you're gonna need to use the included 12 volt adapter unless you have a USB-C, in which case you can just power it from this USB connector down there. You might find that on newer Macs, for example. There's our optical input, which is where we're going to attach an ADAT preamp, if that's something you want to do, which will expand this up to 10 channels. Very, very cool. MIDI in and out. We've got Kensington lock to make sure nobody steals your lovely interface, or make sure if you drop it, it doesn't fall off your desk. And then we have four analog outputs on a TRS quarter inch. Again, we have 1 and 2, which are kind of assigned as your monitor outputs. We have these two, which are available for routing for various purposes, such as setting up cue mixes, perhaps running out to external gear. Lots of fun to be had there. So I thought we'd take a moment and explore what makes this interface tick and what makes it kind of interesting and special. First thing to talk about this one is the low latency that comes along with USB 3 type preamps. It's a very, very, very fast, interface, really fast connection protocol. So what I thought we'd do is I thought we'd try one of the acid tests of latency, which is to try and play some shreddy guitar without using any kind of external processing. We're gonna do input monitoring and we'll do some software monitoring on Logic. I'm gonna use Logic's new Chromaverb, we'll use H-Delay from Waves, and we're gonna use PRS and Waves. What is it, V9, yeah, the V9 supermodel amp. And I'm gonna show you how quickly this tracks and how nice and natural it feels with the super low latency we're able to achieve with the Focusrite. Let's have a listen to that now. So with latency that low, there's really no need for DSP to set up your monitor mixes inside this fella. You can just listen through the plugins that you're going to mix with, which is very, very cool. Nice intuitive way of working, and of course it means you're not stuck with whatever sounds are bundled inside the box. Now, another feature that I wanted to talk about was the air setting on the preamp. Now, this is something Focusrite have done for a long time now, and it basically adds... I suppose you'd call it harmonics. That's harmonics from 10K all the way up to 35K. Yes, you heard that right, 35K, which is well above the spectrum of human hearing. Just adds a sense of kind of breathiness and airiness to a source. I'm not going to try that with an acoustic guitar mic'd with an AKG 414. I will say, however, that if you're listening on your phone or you're listening on laptop speakers, you probably won't get the effect with this one. So throw on some headphones, go and listen through your studio monitors if you really want to get the best out of this little demo. So while the effect is subtle, it's a really nice option to have. The preamp with the air disengaged is nice and clean. It's not got a lot of character, but you don't necessarily want that. There are a lot of plugins out there that'll give you a bit of that preamp character if you want it. However, the air is a nice option to have if you want to add just a little bit of sparkle on the way in. And there are a load of sources that would benefit from that. Overheads, vocals, acoustic guitars. A nice feature to have, I think you'll agree. Anyway, let's talk a little bit about the Control app, which is really elegant, very, very simple to use. We're going to delve into that now. Okay, so we're taking a quick look at the Focusrite Control app that comes with this interface. Let's see what's in here. We'll have a little bit of a play, and we'll see what features we can access. So first of all, we have this little kind of menu at the top, which chooses between output routing and device settings. Let's start with the device settings. We'll see what's available. We've got some sample rate settings over here. On our clock source, either we can be internal, or we can take it from the SPDIF or the ADAT inputs. Monitor controls just determines whether your monitor dial on the front controls outputs 1 or 2. All 4 outputs or none at all. And then we have the 2 inputs over here. You can see this little meter flashing there. If I just clap my hands, currently have this AKG 414 plugged in there just so you can see how that works. We can switch between line and instrument level. And if you look on the front of the interface right there, you can see that little light is coming on to show us that we're switching levels. We can also turn the air control on and off. And again, as I do that, you can see that on the front of the interface, just doing its little thing. Very, very cool. And of course, up here, we can give it some names as well if we want. So let's call that 414. There we go. Lovely. Now over to output routing. Got a whole bunch of options over here. We can essentially set up a whole bunch of custom mixes for various outputs. So over here, just hit this plus there. We've got analog input 1. You can see the gain, or rather level, just sort of coming up there. And then we have input 2 over there we can play with. That's all very good. Hitting this little plus button, we can access either a stereo summed 1 and 2, the SPDIF ins, or the 8 ADAT ins. Excuse that noise. That's the fan on my Mac starting up. It's starting to show its age a little bit now. Anyway, over here, if we turn our attention to this little set of outputs, I'm just going to turn the monitor control up and down on the front of the interface, and you can see in the software, that's turning this little green fella up and down there. Very, very cool. 2 ways to access that. That's nice. This can be either a custom mix. It can either be the playback from your DAW. It can be directly taken from the hardware inputs, or it can be custom mix, which is this business over here. We can separate this out into 2 individual outputs, monitor output 1 and 2. And they're the outputs in the back. We can do the same with 3 and 4, which are your headphone outputs. Very, very cool. We've got dim, we've got mute, as you would expect to see. No dim on the headphones, but that's no big deal. That's neither here nor there. Now, a very cool thing about this one is that there is an accompanying app for your phone and for your tablet, which you can use to set up custom cue mixes and kind of adjust your cue mix on the fly. So you don't need to be next to your recording machine while you're doing that. So it's a really simple and really elegant looking interface, but you can see there is a lot of control available there without going kind of like feature overload and without giving you option anxiety, or without you ever really looking to see where anything is hidden, if you know what I mean. Really cool app, nice bit of design. All right guys, so in a nutshell, that's the Focusrite Clarett 2PREUSB. Really nice, rugged interface, very well designed. Couple of nice little features in there, especially the air on those preamps. Sounds fantastic, and while the Thunderbolt cousins in the range are edging it out ever so slightly in speed, this is gonna be compatible with so many more machines, and it is every bit, well, almost every bit as fast, certainly fast enough for me. Nice simple feature set and a nice elegant app to go along with it. Of course, you can expand this up to 10 preamps if you want to with an ADAT. Really, really, really rather cool. You can also throw it in your bag if you're doing some field recording. It's nice and portable. And if you've got a Mac or you've got a PC with kind of USB 3 connectors, you can bus power this as well, so you don't need to worry about dragging the wall wart out with you. Really nice preamp, big fan of this one. Focusrite are a great company. They always make good stuff, and this is no exception. So anyway, I'm gonna leave that there. My name's Nick for Guitar Interactive Magazine. I'll see you next time.